So let's talk about understanding diversity. So workforce kaleidoscope. Diversity is the key to constant change and advancement in our society. The understanding of diversity begins with the recognition that one of many, we are one. If the whole world was represented as a collection of 100 people, for example, shrink the Earth population to a village of precisely 100 people, with all the existing human ratios remaining the same, it would look something like this. There would be about 57 Asians, 21 Europeans, 14 from the Western Hemisphere, North and South both included, 8 Africans, 52 would be female, 48 would be male, 70 would be non-white, 30 would be white, 70 would be non-Christian, 30 would be Christian, 89 would be heterosexual, 11 homosexual, 59% of the entire world's wealth would be in the hands of only 6 people, and all those 6 people would be citizens of the United States. 80 would live in substandard housing, 70 would be unable to read, 50 would suffer from malnutrition, one would be near death, one would be near birth, only one would have college education, and there would be only one person with a computer. So what is diversity? The state or the fact of being diverse, or difference, unlikeliness, or diversity of opinion. The term diversity is used to refer to many demographic variables, including but not limited to race, religion, color, gender, national origin, disability, sexual orientation, age, education, geographic origin, skill, or characteristics. India's diversity has given the country its unique strength and resilience and richness. Now, what is workplace diversity? Workplace diversity refers to the variety of differences between people in an organization. This sounds simple, but it encompasses race, gender, ethnic group, age, personality, cognitive style, tenure, function, education, background, and more. Now, what is diversity? Diversity is the many type of differences that we recognize in ourselves and in others. Now, there are a lot of society differences, as we can see on the left side: age, gender type, culture, education, sexual orientation, physical, mental abilities, values, marital status, religion. There are also some workplace differences that we can see on the right side, such as management, you have a non-management, techie, you have a non-techies, doctors, nurses, staff, or any other workplace differences. Now, what are the benefits of diversity? Before getting on this, I would just like to mention a point that the average worker in 1917 United States was married, white male, age 29, 12 years of education. That was basically the high school graduation. Children, they had children. They had a housemaker wife, and they worked only in the region where they lived. The new demographic that we have in today's marketplace is women, that account for approximately half of the workforce. Ethnic group and racial groups have grown consistently and expected to double in the next 55 years. The averages of workplace is increasing substantially. The ADA has enabled people with disabilities with opportunities to join the mainstream workforce. Different perspective along with higher creativity will enhance the company performance. By the way, these are the benefits of diversity. Provides opportunity to learn from and about others. Strengthen the ability to compete in the increasingly global market with so many global perspectives. Increases innovation and adds new and creative ideas to the process. Provides different approaches of accomplishing a task that comes from the cumulative experience of so many different cultures and groups. Now, the top 10 economic facts about diversity in the workplace. A diverse workplace drives the economic growth. Such a workplace can capture a greater share of customer market. Recruiting from such a diversified pool of candidates means a lot more qualified workforce. A diverse and inclusive workplace helps businesses avoid employees turnover ratio. Diversity fosters a creative and more innovative work culture. Businesses tend to adapt to our changing nation to be competitive in the economic market. Diversity is the key aspect of entrepreneurialism. Diversity in business ownership, particularly among women of color, is the key to moving our economy forward. Diversity in the workplace is necessary to create a competitive economy in a globalized world. Diversity in the boardroom is needed to leverage a company's full potential. Now, these are some diversity valuing requirements: increasing one's personal awareness, learning to avoid stereotypes, recognizing the worth and dignity of others, treating other people with respect. Now, How cultures affects the way we treat others. Culture is defined as a way of life of a given society passed down from one generation to the next through learning experiences. It is the way of how we do the things around here. Involves beliefs and values as well as assumptions and perceptions and perceptions. Now, what are stereotypes? So imply that everyone in the given category is the same, which is obviously not the case. Often implies undesirable or insulting characteristics that have been these days popularized by social media. Ignores individual experience and expectations. Makes assumptions about the individual and their experiences without any direct knowledge of that person. These assumptions are driven from them just being of a certain type. Rarely comes from the perspective of inside the group. Thus, outsiders often miss much of the important information. Now, how can we confront our bias regarding diversity? First, take an honest evaluation of your attitude and biases. We should be open to change. We should learn to treat the other person with respect and equality. We should learn to integrate people and put our differences aside. We should be able to recognize and acknowledge the needs as well as the contributions of all people. We should work together towards common goals. At the end of the day, respect for everyone is the key towards understanding diversity. Thank you.